actually, this is that Forge World drop pod that I airbrushed the base coats on it, just because it's flat. Now, there's been a lot of guys talking online about the airbrushes, and it can be expensive and so on. I just noticed I got chunks here that I never saw before. I'll just have to paint some damage onto that. Anyhow, there's one leg, or one door. Here's another one. There's been mention online about airbrushes and the cost and all the rest of it. If you can't afford an airbrush, try and go to like a Canadian Tire or something like that and just find a spray can. If it matches similar to the color of what you're using, then use that. Just make sure that it won't affect your plastics. Because nothing can beat the sprayed surface, which makes it look really flat. Now, there's some imperfections on this. You'll see here, you might see there are a couple runs. When I think I mentioned this on a previous video, that's door two, that I sweated it when I first saw it. And then after I realized, after first painted my first drop pod and did all the highlighting and then the weathering, you don't even see it. So don't panic if you're just learning and you find some imperfections like that. Now, if you want it perfect, well, then you'll have to sweat it. But in my experience, don't worry about it. One effect that I might try on this is painting these lights that they cast off the light. I think it's called source lighting, where it gives off that glow. And one of the best examples I've seen of that is Les from Awesome Paint Jobs drop pod. In fact, I think it was this Forge World one too. The whole thing looks like it's glowing from lights on the inside. Just a wonderful job. So there's the base. This was pinned just so that when I go to glue it together, it lines up. Now, I opted in my last video thinking what I was gonna do with these hinges, and I'm not doing anything, to be honest. I'm gonna risk it and see, will these magnets, which I think they will, hold the doors up? Because people are complaining that you set it on the table, the doors come down, and then it breaks the pivots. But I have these on magnets, so it should hold the doors upright, even if you set it down. And then I would set the doors down. If it breaks, well, then I'll have to deal with it at that time. But that's those magnets I put in there. Alrighty, and here's the uprights. So here's the motor unit. The flashing on, or the mold on some of these cables didn't turn out the greatest. There's some breaks in it there. But I'm not going to sweat it. For the amount of work that it would take to try and repair those minor details, I don't think you'd ever see it. And then here's the uprights. These were airbrushed as well. So there's three of them. Compared to the GW, which was five uprights, five legs, this is only three. And the other thing I did with these doors is I grind off the, I think it's called Aquila. Very close to my old dog's name, Tequila. Oh man, I miss that pup. And there is what it'll look like when it's painted. Obviously it'll be red and I'm going to make it silver. Silver base around. One last thing just to mention. Guys, I have had so many really supportive and wonderful comments coming down the pike. I've been trying to post HD videos of the figures and just really supportive and complimentary comments about my painting style and skill, or if I can say skill, because I never thought I had it. It's just been a work in progress for a little over 2 years now. So to every single one of you guys that takes a second just to type in a comment, I really appreciate it. It's been by the support of you guys that it's gotten me better. Just from watching your videos or talking to you guys on Ventrilo or you guys answering posts on other, it's just, I certainly wouldn't be painting let's say, to this level without the support of everybody in the community. So thanks, guys. And lastly, on any of the haters, which has become a cliche online, there's no room for it. Bye-bye.